3 times a year I check my blood glucose level with this device. I don't have any problems, but this is just to be 100% sure. The test strips are inside this container. You can see a 3-digit code on the label. With the strips, there is also this chip which has the same code as on the container. So you have to insert it into the slot of the device. Now I have to insert the battery. I don't use the monitor often, so I keep the battery in its package. If you leave the battery inside without using the monitor for a long time, it can leak and damage the device. When you insert the battery, you can set the date and time. I will skip this part because I will remove the battery after checking my blood sugar level. That is the spring-loaded adjustable lancet. You have to select the desired needle depth according to how soft your skin is. To load it, you have to pull the back part until you hear a click. Then when you press the button, it will be triggered. To change or insert a needle, you have to unscrew the top part. Then carefully take out the needle and discard it. Take a new needle and insert it into the slot. Carefully rotate the plastic tab and remove it. Then screw the top part of the lancet. The needle should be changed after each finger poke once a day or once every 1-2 weeks. The most important thing is that no one else should use the same needle. Now it's time for the test. First, take one strip from the container. Wash your hands with warm water and soap, then dry them with a clean towel or a paper towel. Don't use wet wipes because they may contain certain chemicals that can affect the results. You can use surgical spirit instead of washing your hands, but you have to wait for it to evaporate. Take the test strip and insert it into the slot of the device. Now it is waiting for the blood. Here comes the scary part. Take and load the lancet. Avoid pricking your thumb or your index finger. Gently push the lancet towards your finger and press the button. You may find it less unpleasant if you prick your finger on its side. Don't squeeze your finger too much because this dilutes the specimen with plasma and may affect the results. I'm squeezing it very gently. You need only one drop. Take the device and touch the blood with the top of the test strip. You have to wait several seconds and the result will appear on the screen. Today I have 6.4, which is slightly higher than normal. The table says good and acceptable, but these are quite high blood sugar levels. You want to have a result somewhere between 4 and 6 before the meal, which means that you should not have eaten anything at least 8 hours before the test. The higher levels of sugar in the blood may be caused by stress, an unhealthy diet and many more factors. Don't worry if you have a slightly higher result once in a while. You can do another test the next day or 2 hours after eating. If you have any of the symptoms of diabetes or if your blood sugar continues to be high, you should consult your doctor. Take a paper towel and wipe off the blood from your finger. Pull out the test strip and discard it. I will remove the battery to prevent it from leaking. Yesterday I had a very stressful and exhausting day. I ate a full box of chocolates before going to bed and I slept less than 8 hours. That was not the stressful part, but it may be the reason for my higher blood sugar level today. Oh, by the way, this little bottle contains a glucose control solution. You can use it to check if your device is showing accurate results. That's all for today. I hope this video was helpful. Have a nice day and see you soon.